Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasi. Today we are with another YouTube tutorial video, and in today's video we will be customizing email notification of our Shopify store. So currently when someone orders something from your store, any product from your store, it gets an email notification which looks like this. So that's how the order confirmation email looks like. So that's the subject line, and that's the name of the store. In our case is development store, and that should be the name of the website. And that's how overall order confirmation email look like. And what we're gonna do first, we'll try to add a logo in this email, and we will try to change subject line, and we will try to spice it up a bit so it will look attractive to the customers of your store. So without further ado, let's get into it. And before doing so, make sure to subscribe to the channel, comment on the video below, and let me know what do you like about this channel and what would you like to learn more in Shopify. So let's get into it. So guys, first in this email, we will update our logo, which will show up here. So in order to do so, make sure you're logged into your Shopify backend, and that's how the backend of Shopify store will look like. And after that, click on settings, and from settings click on notifications. That's where all of the notifications from Shopify are showing up. We have order confirmation, order edited, order invoice, order canceled, all of these type of notification which you have the ability to customize from here. And first we'll add our logo, and for that click on customize here. In customize email templates, click on customize, and then from here we will add the logo. So click on choose image, and I'm going to upload my logo. Okay, our logo is uploaded, and now click on done and hit save. Once saved, close this dialog and open it up again from our settings, and then notifications, click on customize again. And now we can see our logo is showing up. And now as you can see that our logo color is blue, but the coloring in our email is like brownish type orange. So what we're gonna do, we'll change it to our color theme, which is blue. And okay, that's close enough. We can match the exact color code by extracting the color from logo, but let's do this for now. And click save again. And again, we'll have to close and open up. Let's change it. And then, okay, here we go. Our coloring has been updated. Okay, now the second step, the second thing which we're gonna do is spice up our subject line. So currently, if you take a look at our subject line, it's like order number 1017 confirmed, which looks like a little boring. So we're gonna spice it up a bit from our notification settings. So we'll click on settings and then notifications. And from there, we'll click on order confirmation. That's the email which we have been receiving. So that's the subject line. And let's change it to a little spicy. So what we can do here is add the first name, whoever added the order. And in order to do so, we will copy this code from curly braces and place it here. Now it will dynamically pull the name of the customers and add it on the subject line. And now order confirm. Let's just say we can ask our customer excited. And as we are in, we are selling clothing stuff, so we are selling t-shirts in our store. If you go to our development store, we have t-shirts which we are selling. So we can write some related content. So that's the title, which says thank you for your purchase. That's the top of the line. And we will say thank you for your purchase, or we can also say we are excited to see you with your new t-shirt. So this line can be more of related to your store, whatever you're selling. So if you're selling like clothing, you can write something related to that. If you're selling a food item, you can write something that we are excited about your new food, or whatever you want to write down here. Okay, so now after making the text changes, scroll down, and where's our save button here? Okay, here's the save button. Click on save button and go back to the customize to see if our text changes have been applied or not. And now click the back button and go to customize again. And here we go, our text changes has been updated, our logo has been updated. And at the end of the video, I'll also send a test, or I'll also add a test order and received an order confirmation email to make sure that the changes which we made is actually updated or not. And guys, we can also use liquid variables. So we have variables from Shopify, which are called liquid variables, through which we can pull customer information and print it on our emails. You can find all of the liquid variables from here. So let's open it up and try to get familiarity with that email variables. So these are all of the email variables which we can use. So if we will add email in curly braces in our email template like this, we will get the email associated with the order. So when customer filled up the email, we can display that email through that property, which we can use under curly braces. Similarly, we have multiple variables. As you can see, order name is same as name. So we have multiple variables we can use here. We can print shop name, we can print shop phone. So there are a lot of variables which we can use. We can also see what they are printing. So let's try add in the customer name, which we already added here. So where is that? I'm trying to show you guys what information which we can pull, whatever is filled by the customer. Customer. Containing the attributes of the customer. Okay, so they have completely different page showing customer attribute, and here it is. So these are all of the customer liquid objects which we can add and get the value from them. So similarly, how we did here, customer first name. Now let's add a test order and see we are showing up the customer first name here. And hit save before we doing that, and let's place a test order in order to make sure that the logo which we updated and the first name which we added on the subject line is showing up. So I'm just going to add a test order in order to do so. Okay, I'm going to add my email here, since pro@gmail.com. okay, So let's add in my name and a testing address for now. City, postal code, and let's click on continue to shopping. Continue to payment, as it's I just changed it to $0, so it's not going to charge me anything, and just send the order email. Okay, our order is being processed and we should have an email now. Okay, now let's go back to our inbox, and here we have our order confirmation email, and here's the name, but it didn't show my first name. It should show my first name. I think we put a wrong variable, so it should be, I guess, billing first name. So we added customer first name. So if we go to liquid variables, so that should be added first name of the customers. Okay, we added a wrong liquid variable. Now we're gonna add a right liquid variable and test from another notification email to how it works. And notifications, here we are, and order confirmation. So now we will replace our customer first name with billing address first name. Weird, why it's showing up the wrong name? Billing address, customer information, shipping address, billing address, contact information. Okay, now hit save and let's try out another order. Okay guys, so I added another test order, and now our shipping address first name and last name is my name, Bilal Naseed, same as billing address. And now let's go to our order confirmation email. So that's our order confirmation email, and as you can see, we have my name showing up, which says, Bilal, are you excited? And we are excited to see you with your new t-shirt, and we have our logo, and our changes which we made has been updated. We also updated the color, so as you can see, we have our color here. And that's it for the tutorial, guys. I hope you guys liked it. A short video for you guys in order to explain how the email template works and how the liquid objects you can add into your email to customize your email template. And if you like this video, don't forget to comment, like, and make sure you subscribe to the channel. Until next video, have a great day.